Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon for the Commodore Amiga Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We are playing... Well, we're playing. We're going to go to the... or a swamp to get a swamp lily as part of an antidote for the fisherman's daughter. So, that's the only other thing I know to do except to go to, what's it called? Get the name of this place. Burnville. To, well, see more of the game and stuff. And we have a few quests to do there. NPCs in Spannenberg want us to contact some NPCs in Burnville. What I did off screen, memorize these spells, of course, was made a lot easier as I'm wearing this Lich Crown, which is pretty awesome, which gives plus 50 to reading magic, so my reading magic is 73% out of 50. Pretty awesome. And Nelvin's is just in it, 62% out of 99. Was that the read magic? Yeah. Because he has this necromancer dagger, which gives you plus 25 to read magic. So now that I'm probably going to use this throwing sickle once he's out of sling stones. I just put this back because he's done reading magic now. So, the spells we have... Oh, we can't cast any spells in here. Anyway, I just read them off. We got magical... Well, I got... Citrine has Magical Torch and Light, which they both provide light, I'm pretty sure, so I'm not sure what the difference is. She has Hurry, which is basically haste. Which is for one person, one round. I might as well just have saved my spell learning points and not even use that. I mean, maybe I'll use it now and again. Just on Edgel or something. I don't know if it ages people like in Amberstar, though. I never saw anybody. I never noticed anyone age in Amberstar when I used it. So, and we also have Blink, which I guess is... move or jump. It teleports a person or group. I have a listing of spells, and the listing of spells is often not the same word or words as in the game itself. So, and we have magical weapon, which is increases your attack power. So that's that. And then Nelvin couldn't learn much. He's almost at a spell learning points. Actually, with four, he can't, you know, learn any of the other spells I have for him. So he has Earth Slide, which attacks... It says it attacks some enemies. I'm guessing it's a group of enemies. And he has Magical Arrows, which is pretty cool. So these are the spells he has available, and we might as well go on our way. I don't know if I should find those lizards. I want to fight those lizards again. I wish I could call the horse to us. I'd walk across the desert and then go find the... have the lizards attack me, and then I'd call the horse to me. But instead we wander around, and time passes very quickly. I suppose I'll do the same as I last time. If it gets dark, I'll head back. And then... I'll sleep at the house again, I guess. Oh, what are these? Oh, they used to use the Wind Pearl Zone? Pretty interesting. It looks like a broken, like a wind gate or something, maybe. Try going straight back, more or less. They make it so you can't go in a straight line. There's always going to be something in your way, no matter where you're positioned on the map. We left our horse up here then. Suddenly, the group. Okay. Oh, they're in darkness. Look at that. Desert lizard. Okay, good. Been wanting to test my mettle against them. Alright, so attack. Attack. She needs arrows. Defend the lame spell. Seven damage. Let's both attack this one for now. No damage. These things wiped the floor with us last time I came across them. Of course, at that point it was just me and Agile, and that was... we were many levels lower. The spells are failing, their attacks are failing. I almost feel sorry for these things. Almost. Cannot penetrate the magical aura. I really just want Nelvin to use up those stones. We just found them. Oh, actually 4 points on Agile. Sweet. Desert Lizard rematch. Going quite well. No! You cannot get away. It's too fast. And Selena's never gonna hit it. But we have Nelvin and his spells, actually. So now we have magical arrows. Let's try Earth Slide. That's our new one. Okay, it's a group. That's cool. He's gonna miss, though. Right, he missed because he moved. It moved. We need speed for the mage. And the healer. Oh, whenever we get one. Maybe magical arrow will hit the target no matter what. That'd be cool. You know what? How about aim here, so when it flees, it'll just walk into it, right? What's the sign to attack? Nope. Here we go. 2 points. Okay, good. Put Earth Slide here, then. Spell failed. Come on, Nilvin. You can do it. Poof. Alright. We got 4 rations. Lizard steaks for everyone. Awesome. That works. So where's the horse? Try my light spell. So we've got light, a lot more casts of light than magical torch. Wrong area. Okay, so light does that. What about magical torch? Adds to it? Oh. Alright, horsey. Oh, there you are. Oh wait, we were successful. Against the Desert Lizard Menace. So now, gotta go rest until morning, and then we'll really head out into the for the swamp for real. Night night. He needs more. He's got too much mana or something. I need to learn how to get that back more effectively. So now we wait for 8 hours. There's a problem with this though, it's gonna be nighttime again. Yep. We're bedridden, so now I have to wait 8 hours. To sleep 8 hours? It's a vicious cycle here. Oh, we're using food, too. 3? I can't stop everyone from using food, but I can. This way I only waste 1 ration. I forget, we can't sleep yet, right? Alright, so now we have to sleep. We have to wait 8 hours. Again. This is what I have to do to start out in the morning. When we have light. For the whole screen, because it's one. I want to light up the whole screen, not just a little circle around us. Alright, so we slept till dawn. Wasted just 1 ration. Now we can go. What was that, like 3 days now? So, saving. Wow. Thank you. Okay, so from here, I think I'm just gonna go straight north. There's that thing. So if you go straight north, we come across that. I wonder what the... what it's all about. So what the swamp is going to be as problematic as the swamp in Amberstar? We reached the other side, so now... oh, that's cool! Look at that! That is awesome. So from here... I'll just illustrate for you guys what I'm thinking of here. Alright, so we were here. I'm pretty sure this is the home, so we headed straight north. So we're like over here. This kind of reddish-brownish area is usually a swamp. Strange to have it near a mountain, though. Well, it might be there, actually. Unless we're gonna get hurt trying to cross that. And try to find the, you know, smallest area. Smallest distance, which should probably be, like, either here or over here. So now we're on the shore here. Somewhere, probably right near the mountain, so we need to head east. Gotta get my... oh. It looks swampy. Oh, look at that. Yep. Swampy over there. So maybe that's what we're looking for. It keeps... I'm trying to cycle through. No, never mind. Oh, we're on the edge. On the very edge here. Yeah, I can't... alright. So it's not east, we're more west... I mean, we're more east than I thought we were. A bridge. Oh, are we right by the Tower of the Alchemists right now? No, I don't know. I can't see the bridge on the map. So I'm not sure what we just crossed. Well, can we cross here? Should we stay on the... that, those bubbles are probably damaging. That's what it was like in Ambermoon, Amberstar. Alright, well, I need more light, so maybe we can rest here. Maybe we should head out on foot, or would the horse protect us? I don't know. Oh, is this the swamp lily? Got it. Was that easy? Okay. I thought I'd have to fight some stuff to get it. Some beasties or something. Examine this. Alright, normal item. Okay. Well, we got it. We got the swamp lily, so that was quick. So now we need to go to where? Swamp lily. Spring of life on a high plateau in the mountains to the east. Oh, I think I know where that is. North past chain of mountains. Pass going east to river. Use key in the door tests. Or to pass tests. And then at the spring we find the file. So I'm thinking that it's this. The spring of life. Alright, so let's back and do that. I didn't know finally the swamp lily was going to be so easy. Now bridge this way, right? No? Yeah, we don't get hurt on the horse. I mean, we would have gotten hurt already. Watch, unbeknownst to me, your horse can die. Huh. I'm kind of clueless as to how I got over here, actually. Well, it must have been here. Here's the bridge, okay. Now we just find the mountains and we head south. There's a lot of garbage around here. Look at all this stuff. Look at all these dead trees. What the hell happened? Ah, that's it. That's what we're looking for. I didn't know we could get through to the other side here. This is what we're looking for. What did it say? Pass going east to a river. It's not really a river, this is like the ocean. Unless they mean this this river. Next to the door is a large marble sign which says, "Welcome to the Spring of Life. Those that are worthy may make use of it." Okay. I pray that we will be worthy then. They're gonna give us some kind of tests. I don't know the nature of these tests. Is it gonna be trivia or defeat this monster? On the door is the symbol of Gala, the goddess of life. Well, we use the key, right? Anthony's key. Unlocked. As you open the door, the scent of spring flowers surrounds you and you hear quiet, festive music. Really? Festive music. Temple of Gala. Awesome. New music. In the sights here. Obviously we're going to examine the statue there, but let's look around a little. Nothing. Interesting. No matter where we go, the statue is facing us. Deep in the crystal ball, strange runes appear. Hooray. It's not long, though. Strange runes. A-H-E? No. Well, that's a C. That's a T. Okay, there is this is the H, I think. There is A is A L always. Yeah, this is there is always A. Way? There is always a way. Thank you for that. I don't know what it means, but. No. Touch. Got doors on that side. Let's map out the room though. So the map looks nice and complete. Okay, there's a secret wall. Didn't even mean to hit that. So there's another thing here. I was just trying to map out the room. I didn't know I was gonna. Then I thought I was clipping through the wall. Okay, so we should be good on this end. I wonder if there's any more secret doors. I mean, walls. Probably not where there's, windows. That's just the shadow of the door, I guess. I'm getting very cautious here. This seems to be a statue of Gala. Unfortunately, the windows allow very little light into the hall, so you cannot see it very clearly. Alright, well, nothing happens. And then we've got these doors. Interesting. A table here? On the table is a strange, large stone and a long piece of iron. A flint and iron. I've seen that for sale in places. Maybe we use that to light the orbs or whatever those are. If there's gonna be any beasties here, or just... Oh. Hello? How is that? You see a strange pulsating light ahead. Should Citrine touch the strange light? Maybe not yet. Saving again. Let me do that.